I begin my story out in West Virginia in a little college. All the student body only cared for football, never mind the knowledge. Never mind the sheepskin, they preferred the pigskin, seemed to have it in their bones. They knew all about it, couldn't live without it, all except a certain Mr. Jamboree Jones. He played the clarinet with all his might. He practiced night and day. He practiced day and night. No running up the field for Mr. Jones. He'd rather run up the scale and down the scale. What tones, even though his buddies always cut their studies to attend a rally. While they all were rootin', you could hear him tootin', what's become of Sally? How they used to hate him, co-eds wouldn't date him, thought he was an awful bore. But he liked his rhythm more than being with him, so he only turned around and practiced some more. Meanwhile, the team marched on to greater fame, till they were asked to play that famous Rose Bowl game. And on that day of days, the students beat. What did they do when the team marched on the field? They screamed. From the kickoff, they pulled every trick off, but they couldn't win it. Instead of going forwards, they were going backwards about a mile a minute. Seeing their position, they called intermission, and they heard the referee say, 17 to nothing, ain't exactly nothing, and you've only got about a minute to play. Then from the stands, there came a distant wail, and it was Jamboree, a swinging hold'em yell. And all the students then began to yell. The players marched up the field and down the field. Pell-mell. Now on a certain West Virginia hill, there stands that college still, just as it always will. And there's a picture in its Hall of Fame. You'll see the boy in the frame who won that game, Jamboree Jones. Jamboree Jones, Jamboree Jones is the gentleman's name. Jamboree Jones is the gentleman's name.